Hello everyone, Catweazle here, welcome to the channel and welcome back to our new playthrough of Eldritch Horror Rise of the Elder Things, where we're now moving into turn one. So let's have a very quick refresher of where everybody is. Our first player, as decided by the team, will be Wendy Adams. Wendy Adams is currently at Eastern Russia at space 16. She will be followed by Rex Murphy, who is up at space 1 in Juneau, Alaska. After him, it will be Jenny Barnes, who's at space 8 here in the Bahamas. And last but not least, we have Monterey Jack, who is at the Pyramids. We have one gate, a blue constellation gate at Tokyo, that is guarded by a rather nasty fire vampire, one of the few monsters in Eldritch Horror that actually moves around. And it's not a nice fellow. We will be looking to avoid it. But we're gonna have to take a few risks first. Just before we move into the action phase, let's just take a quick look again at each of our investigators. And in any case, we've got to see if any one of them wants to take the prelude up on its offer. So let's go to our first player, who is Wendy Adams. And here we are with Wendy. She's got the first player token there. And what is she going to do as regards the prelude? Well, she's going to go for it. So the first thing she's going to impair is going to be strength. So a strength is going to go down to 1. And that means she could pick 2 weapons from the asset deck. So we'll give it a quick shuffle. And then we'll go through the deck. First 2 weapons we pick up, we will then decide which we're going to keep. So there we go. Let's do a cut. And we have a missionary. Holy water, that's just an item, it doesn't count as a weapon. Protective amulet is an item. A lavish feast, don't think that's a weapon. A specialist is an ally. Ooh, tear gas, item, weapon, yeah, rather crap as well. So we've got tear gas and ancient tome, no. Occult text, no. Security squad, no, it's an ally. King James Bible is a tome. Secret page is a tome. Esteemed author is an ally. Come on, how many weapons? Must be more than this. Profane tome. Syndicate agent. Blimey, don't think we've got any. Genealogy research. Ward evil, that's a service. Another ally. Another ally, come on! An axe. So we've got 2 crappy weapons. Sorry about that, Wendy, but you've got a choice between tear gas and an axe. So let's have a look at those. See which one we're going to pick. So cost 1, tear gas. Item weapon. You may discard this card and re-roll up to 2 dice when resolving a strength test during a combat encounter. In addition, reduce the monster's damage by 2 to a minimum of 1. Actually, that isn't bad. But it's a discard. That's the problem. So we can only use it once. And the axe, gain plus 2 strength during combat encounters. You may spend 2 sanity to re-roll any number of dice when resolving a strength test during a combat encounter. I think this is the one that we will take, because the other one, though it's quite strong, is just a discard. This does give her plus 2 strength, and her strength is now down at 1 because it has been impaired. So she will take the axe and the tear gas will go away. Okay, so that is the first impair that she's took on. The second one is to impair her will. So we'll put that there. And do a quick shuffle of these, a quick cut, and then we will take off the back, and she is blessed. So that's good news. So she's got an axe and she is blessed. So that is it for Wendy. She's now ready to rock and roll. But after Wendy, we'll have a look at and refresh our memories about the rest of the team. So next up is our second player, who will be Rex Murphy. And here is Rex. Well, Rex is not taking the prelude up on its offer, so he is not going to impair any of his skills. So he is just going to play second player, just to refresh you about where he is up to. He's only got the lucky talisman and he still has his cursed condition. So that is Rex. Our third player will be Jenny Barnes. Let's have a quick look at her. And here's Jenny. Jenny has a fine jewellery. She also has the 0.25 automatic. And she has also decided that she won't be taking the prelude up on its offer either. So she will not be impairing any skills. So that is it for Jenny. And our final player will be Monterey Jack. And here's Monterey. Monterey has his treasure map. Obviously, he needs to go to Rome to have a look at that. He's got a bullwhip and he is also not going to impair any of his abilities in order to take advantage of the prelude's offer. So the only person who has took advantage of that offer has been Wendy. She got herself an axe and she has got herself a blessed condition. Okay, so that's all our investigators. Let's get right across to the action phase and it's Wendy Adams who will be our first player. Before his strange disappearance, Wendy's father had taught her to be very careful of who to trust. He had told her the day would come when he would not be around, and when that day came, only the associates in the back of his old diary would know what to do. Clutching the torn page and finally free of that awful orphanage, she set off to find them and to find some answers. Wendy looked at the names on the page, reciting them like a mantra in her head. Monterey Jack, Jenny Barnes, Rex Murphy, Tommy Muldoon, Tony Morgan, Silas Marsh, Akachi Onyele, Ursula Downs. Ursula Downs? Wendy knew that name. She was a nice explorer lady that had used to bring her gifts when she came to see her father. But now, she too was also missing whilst looking for the Miskatonic Antarctic expedition. Russia had not yielded any information, so it was time to try and find another lead back at her father's old office in Tokyo. And that's where we are up to with Wendy. Thanks to the flavour text there to Wendy's player Lawrence. Now, what Wendy going to do for her first action? Well, for her first action, Wendy is going to prepare for travel and she's going to get herself a train ticket. For her second action, she's going to move to Tunguska, then she's going to spend the train ticket and she is going to go to Vladivostok. What we are doing here is we are trying to make use of her elusive ability. Hopefully she'll be able to get into that gate in Tokyo while eluding the fire vampire. Bit of a risk because if there's a reckoning, the fire vampire will move towards her. But there are only two reckoning cards in the first five. So less than half, it's a 2 out of 5 chance, isn't it? So less than half that we will get a reckoning. Hopefully we won't, and the fire vampire's reckoning effect won't come into play. So that is it for Wendy. Next up, we have Rex Murphy. Rex had been chasing a story about a new gold strike in Juneau, Alaska, but the Alaskan story had turned out to be a bust. 3 weeks backpacking in the frozen mountains for nothing but freezing feet and a streaming cold. To rub salt into the wound, Rex had returned to Juneau just as rumours were filtering back from Argentina that the Miskatonic Antarctic expedition had run into some serious trouble. Rex had only missed joining the expedition himself because of that bogus gold strike. Just his usual bad luck to back the wrong horse and to miss the breaking story, he thought, completely oblivious to the fact that he would have been equally involved in any catastrophe that had befallen the expedition. Returning to his hotel to pack and leave, Rex considered if he could possibly catch a steamer and head down south to cover the expedition story. As Rex checked out of the hotel, the desk clerk handed him a 2-week-old telegram that had arrived while Rex was out on the trail looking for his phantom Spanish conquistador mine. Ursula Downs had wired him to tell of her decision to suspend her own Amazon expedition and head up an Antarctic rescue mission. Would Rex care to come along? Rex had met earlier when travelling in Brazil a few short months earlier. He had written a story about the young female explorer who was mapping the great South American river basin. The moderately successful piece had been entitled America's Amazon Adventuress, which had afforded Downs some wry amusement, and it had meant that they had stayed in touch. Now she had sent Rex this telegram, a chance for Rex to be involved in and to report firsthand on one of the most daring rescues in history. Rex let out an enthusiastic yelp and resolved to accept the invitation immediately. Running to the Juneau post office, he quickly composed his reply there and then. As he had paid the clerk and turned to dash down to the shipping office, the weekly mail arrived, including copies of the previous day's San Francisco newspapers. Rex grabbed a copy of the San Francisco Chronicle. The headline stated it had now been several days since anything had been heard from Downs or from the Antarctic, and now winter was closing in. So that is Rex, and he is ready to go. Okay, what's the first thing that Rex is going to do? Well, he's going to use his own special action, and that means he uses his influence and he can pick out any assets from the reserve that are less than his influence. As part of his setup, he improved his influence, so that's now 4, so he can take assets worth a total of 3. Let's go down to the asset reserve and see what he's going to pick. And here's the asset reserve. So he's going to pick the bandages for 1, the specialized training for 1, and the arcane manuscripts for 1, for a total of 3. The Silver Twilight Ritual, he's going to leave there. We'll move it up. So let's have a look at what he has picked. So bandages, a cost of 1. It's an item. You may discard this card to prevent an investigator on your space from losing up to 2 health. So that'll be extremely useful for Rex. And next is the specialized training. So this also is a cost of 1. It's a task. When you perform a focus action, you may also consult experts to train you, and that'll be a will check. If you pass, discard this card and improve 1 skill of your choice. So pretty good. So we'll take that. And finally, he is going to take the arcane manuscripts. Item, tome, gain +1 lore when resolving spell effects. So not bad. Could be worth handing this off to Wendy, who has excellent lore. So he has took those 3 items. So we now need to replace them in the reserve, which is the whole point, because we're hoping to cycle through the deck a bit, because we have Jenny Barnes. So let's have a little shuffle, and we will cut the deck. And what do we get? First of all, we get a weapon. Single cost, the 38 revolver. Item weapon, gain +2 strength during combat encounters. Very good. Next we have the Mystic Bounty Hunter. Cost of 2, an ally. Gain +1 strength during combat encounters. Gain +2 lore when resolving spell effects. That's a nice ally. It has 2 bonuses. Put her there. And finally we get fresh fruit rubbish. So item, when you perform a rest action, you may discard this card to recover 1 additional health and 1 additional sanity. In fact, it's not a bad card. If you're in a bad way, it's an excellent card. So fresh fruit. But that might be something we leave for Rex to pick up in a later turn with his ability. Sort of concentrate on the Mystic Bounty Hunter, the Silver Twilight Ritual, and the revolver, I think. Okay, so that is our new reserve. We'll put the deck back. And Let's move back up to Juneau, Alaska, and find out what Rex is going to do with the rest of his actions. And here we are back with Rex. So for his last action, he is going to move to San Francisco. And that is the end of his action phase. Next will be Jenny Barnes. Jenny had been unable to locate her sister in the Caribbean. Despite her resources and wealth, she came up empty-handed, but rumours abounded. A woman matching her sister's description was seen in the company of suspicious hooded figures and had boarded a ship to Mexico. Could her sister be there? Or was it just another clue to her whereabouts? Worse yet, rumours of something terrible happening in the Antarctic surfaced, and that seemed to connect with the hooded figures, supposedly with her sister. There was so much more to this story than Jenny could guess at. Well, with a martini in hand, Jenny boarded a chartered vessel to Mexico in search of clues and adventure. So thanks to Doug for that bit of flavour text. And what is Jenny going to do? Well, she's going to have a martini. And she's going to get on that charter vessel and she's going to go to Space 7, where we have a clue. For her second action, she is going to use her special ability and she is going to do a spot of shopping. So we'll go down to the reserve in a moment, but we've got to do her roll. So let's just refresh our memories on what a special ability is. As an action, you or another investigator on a city space may perform an acquire assets action and gain +2 influence during that action. So she's got 4 influence anyway. That's going to be 6 influence. She also has her mind jewelry, so she will be able to add an additional pip to a die that we roll. So we need 6 dice. There we go. We could do with that result. Let's see what she gets. Oh, I've also got a brand new dice cup. Funky, eh? So, not quite an elder sign, but a nice little pentagram on it. Isn't it lovely? Right. Come on, Jenny. Oh, what a roll from Jenny. She's on fire, man. So, we've got success. 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 4 successes. We're going to take this four and use her fine jewellery. That becomes a 5. We have 5 successes. Let's move those down to the asset reserve. Let's move the camera down to the asset reserve. And here we are at the asset reserve. And I think what we're going to do is Jenny's player said we would take a debt condition if it warranted it. And I think it does. And the reason for that is we've got 5 successes with a debt condition, which remember she can get rid of because of daddy. She would have 7 successes. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. We could completely clear that off because we get a revolver because Jenny's player wants influence first, any items with influence and then strength. The revolver's got strength. We've got strength off the Mystic Bounty Hunter. The Silver Twilight Ritual is quite good. It can move Doom back by 1. So let's take that as well. And then we may as well, because we're taking a debt condition, we would have 1 success over. So we may as well buy the fresh fruit. As mentioned, if you rest, you do get an additional sanity or an additional health. Oh no, see, if you rest, say you took sanity, you would get a health and another sanity as well. It says 1 additional sanity and 1 additional health. So it isn't too bad a card, actually. It's better than food in Arkham Horror, anyway. So we will take all of those. So let's have a look. The Silver Twilight Ritual. That is a service. When you gain this card, immediately retreat Doom by 1, then discard this card. So we'll do that. That immediately gets discarded. And Doom goes up to 17. It doesn't matter that Doom started at 16. You can move it further back. So that's fine. So we've moved it back to 17. She's also going to take the 38 revolver. Item weapon. gain 2 strength during combat encounters. So she's already got good strength. Now she's also packing some heat. What else do you do when you go to Mexico on holiday? That's right, you get yourself some shooting irons. So she's got a 38 revolver. Put that on the player tray. She has also got an ally in the Mystic Bounty Hunter. So she's pitched up at a port in Mexico and she's been approached by this ally. So we'll gain +1 strength during combat encounters and +2 lore when resolving spell effects. Her lore isn't that brilliant, but if she ever bumps into Wendy Adams, then the Mystic Bounty Hunter can join her. So excellent. And we've already discussed the fresh fruit. When you do a rest, you'll also get an additional health and an additional sanity. So let's take that. And what it does do is it completely clears the reserve again. So it will give us an opportunity to see some more cards. But first things first, she did take a deck condition. So here we are. Here's the deal deck with them all in, along with dark packs and agreements and other nasty stuff. And once again, I show myself up with my rubbish shuffling. Right, there we go. We'll do a cut. We'll cut it short. And so there is her deck condition. Local action. Test influence. If you pass, discard this card. On a reckoning, some men have come to collect your debt. Flip this card. So again, we're hoping we do not get a reckoning. But with Daddy, she can get rid of this card. I'll just check when she can get rid of it. Once per round, when you or another investigator gains a deck condition, that investigator may discard that condition. So they're going to do it now. She's going to get rid of it now. Goes straight back in the deck. And it's unlikely we're going to get another deck condition. So this turn. So Daddy has sorted that out. Let us refresh this deck. The reserve. And see what goodies will be on offer for next turn. So I think while we've got some strong asset strippers like Rex and Jenny, let's try and rifle through this deck as quickly as possible. There is some strong stuff in here, so let's see if we can get any of it. Right, our first replacement asset is the Arcane Assistant, an ally. Roll one additional die when resolving a lore test as part of a spell effect. Cool. Next, we have, oh, the double-barreled shotgun. We love it. Item weapon, gain +4 strength during combat encounters. Each 6 you roll when resolving a strength test during a combat encounter counts as 2 successes. This is exactly the sort of thing we want to be promoting to the reserve. Next, we have a blunderbuss. Oh, we're getting all the weapons out. Item weapon. When resolving a combat encounter, you may gain +2 strength. If you do, each 6 you roll when resolving a strength test during combat encounter counts as 2 successes. And each 1, though, will negate a success. So I'm sure Lawrence, Wendy's player, is looking at this going, why didn't they come out when I impaired my strength? Sorry, Lawrence. And finally, we get the Urban Guide. Ooh, another good one. Ally. If you are on a city space, investigators on your space roll 1 additional die when resolving tests, except when resolving other world encounters. So that'd be good for Rex. I want to keep him in a city, ideally London, generating clues. The Urban Guide would be very, very useful. So if you can get to London and get the Urban Guide, that'd be excellent. So let's put the deck back. That is the refreshed reserve. Let's go back up to see Jenny. Right, so here's Jenny. She's on space 7. There's a clue there, so hopefully she will look to pick that up during the encounter phase. That is the end of Jenny's action phase. So let's get across to the pyramids and see how Monterey Jack is getting along. Wiping his brow while excavating under the hot Egyptian sun, Monterey Jack was here following a rumour of buried treasure. The clues he'd heard had directed him to this site, and when he had started digging, he had suddenly hit something, a wooden trunk. How pirates had got this far inland he didn't know, but he knew a good thing when he had found it. Taking out his lock-picking tools, he quickly made short work of the old lock and opened the chest to find a rolled up paper. Disappointed, he took it out, but then he realised it was a treasure map to a location that looked like Rome. Returning to his hotel in Cairo, a message was waiting for him at the front desk. It appeared that one of his colleagues, Ursula Downs, had disappeared somewhere in the southern pole. Reading the telegram made him remember rumours Ursula had mentioned previously about ruins in the heart of Africa. Jack had a decision to make. Okay, thanks to Mark there for his flavour text for Monterey Jack, who is at the pyramids. As we know, during the setup phase, he got himself a treasure map. So now we know how he did it. So what is he going to do? Well, for his first action, he's going to cogitate on what he's found and focus. So he's now got a focus token, which is excellent. For his next action, he is going to move to Rome. Surprisingly enough, he's decided that the treasure map is too much of a lure. So he has moved to Rome. And that is the end of his action phase. And it's the end of the action phase for all our investigators. Next up, the encounter phase. And here we are at the encounter phase, and our first player is Wendy Adams, the newly blessed Wendy Adams. So let's have some blessed dice to go with it. So that's excellent. And what she's going to do, she's in Vladivostok. It's a wilderness space, so she's going to have a generic wilderness encounter. So let's dig the deck out. Here it is, the generic deck. As ever, what we'll do is we'll give it a quick shuffle. In so much as I shuffle anything. There we go. And quick cut. And let's read our wilderness option. You try to kick open the door of an abandoned shack. Test strength. Let's have a look at what strength is. It's currently one, I think. Now, with the axe, she's got an axe and she's trying to kick the door in, but the axe only helps, unfortunately, on combat encounters, so she's got one blessed die. Come on. You can do it, Wendy. Come on. Of course you can. A five. Were you worried there, Lawrence? No need. I'm rolling, buddy. Right. If you pass, the lock breaks and inside you find something useful. Gain one random item asset from the deck. So, I know some people like to read the whole thing, so there you go. But the end of that was the fail, so I'm not interested in that. What we are interested in, is it from the deck? Just check, yeah, it's asset is from the deck. So we'll keep another quick shuffle, a quick cut, and then we will pick, is it an item asset? Yep. So we'll do a cut, and the first thing we come across with item on it. That's a trinket. That's a service. This is an item, mysterious tome. So she found a mysterious tome in the abandoned shack. When you spend a focus to re-roll a die, when resolving a law or a will test, you may re-roll up to two dice instead. So that's a good find. Because she has got excellent lore. So, brilliant stuff. She has found a mysterious tome in the abandoned shack. Good, good. And that is the end of her encounter phase. So, we'll put that back. Put the deck back. Excellent. Well done, Wendy. And after her, it'll be Rex Murphy, and he's in San Francisco. And here's Rex. And he'd love to be rolling blue dice, but he won't be. He'll be rolling them. So, let's see how he'll get on. But let's remember, he does have his magical talisman, is it? Yeah, his lucky talisman. And it may well need to be lucky. So, there we go. And set up. Can we see that? We can. Let's get the dice cut, funky new dice cut. And he is going to have a San Francisco encounter. So that is the Green America's deck. And here it is. Quick shuffle. Quick cut. Let's see what he gets. San Francisco. You ask occultist John Canby for help. Test influence. Well, that is one of his better traits. He has an influence now of 4, so he gets 4 cursed dice. We need a 6. Come on. Oh, is there anything he can do to bump that up? He does have some stuff that he's just picked up. No. So what he's got to do is he's got to use his lucky talisman. And he's got to re-roll these dice. Come on, Rex. No. So I can see I'm going to have a lot of fun with Rex. So he's failed. Ooh. If you pass, his vast knowledge allows you to enhance your abilities, improve one skill of your choice. If you fail, you are horrified to learn that the next day that he was torn to pieces, gain a despair condition. Well, so it begins. Chrissy, are you ready? Despair. I think it's a madness condition. Just let me flick through till I find one. Yes, it is. Right. So this isn't a good start, is it? And despair is a bad one, I think. So at least Rex is being thematic. Oh, shuffling. Rubbish. Cut. Take off the bottom of the deck. Hallucinations, no. Paranoia, no. Amnesia, no. Amnesia, no. Hunger, no. Despair, yes. That looks like Rex, doesn't it? So, madness. When you perform a rest action, you cannot recover sanity. Flip this card. On. Oh, you see what I mean? You don't even get a roll on a rest action. You have to flip the card. The roll will be on the other side. It'll be somewhat horrible. On a reckoning, you just lose 1 sanity. So, it's a good job he's got 7 sanity. What an awful card. Right, so got despair along with being cursed. Damn. But there's not much you can do. You, as an investigator, you have to do something. So there's a good chance you'll be rolling each turn. So as George A mentioned, try and keep your rolls down. So which is why we're doing normal encounters. If we were closing a gate or we were like trying to pick up a clue or something of that nature, then we would be doing more than one roll. Unfortunately, he was unable to succeed. So let's put that deck back. And that is pretty grim. That is it for Rex. Next up, oh, put those back. The ones I was looking through, put them there. Right. So that is it for Rex. And next up, we move on to Jenny Barnes. And here we are with Jenny. So she won't be using red dice. No, sir. You'll be using some nice white ones, which are much better than the horrible red ones. Now, she is at space 7. She's not going to do a generic city encounter because she's going to try and pick up that clue. We are not in Antarctica, so we will use the normal research deck for the elder things. So here we go. She's in a city. You meet your companion in an abandoned warehouse only to find that he has betrayed you. Discard 1 ally asset. Well, we've got a bloody ally asset as well. Which is, of course, that really good mystic bounty hunter who's turned out to be a traitor. Damn it! So, discard her. So that was a waste of 3 influence. successes. Then an elder thing monster ambushes you. Oh my god. Let's get the elder thing. As you know, we had sort of taken this out at the beginning of the game, took it out of the monster bag. Here it is. As you can see, what a nice piece of work it is. So it's 3 on a will test. Strength test is -1. We've got to get at least 2 successes, and it's got 3 toughness. At least all it is an ambush. Let's have a look at this card. What a horrible card. And I've had loads of people saying, oh, Rising Elder things, dead easy. Right, yeah, so we just do the combat, don't we? So first thing is she's got to do a will test. Her will is 3. So she's got to get 3 successes here. She does have the 38 revolver, and she does have the 2.5 automatic. But let's do the will test first. Doesn't have any rerolls or anything. She gets 1 success. So that means she loses 2. So she put this in. She is down to 3 sanity. So 3 sanity for Jenny. And then she goes on to the combat. So it's strength -1. She does have the 2.5 automatic and the revolver. So it'll be strength -1. 38 revolver, she gains +2 to her strength, so that puts her up to 5. And we roll 1 additional die when resolving a strength test during a combat encounter, so that will be 6. -1 is down to 5. I believe rolling additional die can add on. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Come on Jenny, we need a good roll. She gets 2 successes. She does not kill the elder thing, because it has a toughness of 3, but she did get 2 successes, so she didn't take any damage. Excellent. Goes away, because it was an ambush, and we've just lost 2 sanity. But all in all, her and Rex haven't had a very good encounter phase whatsoever. Let's read to the end of the encounter. If you pass the strength test, which we did, you question your former companion at length, gain this clue and retreat Doom by 1. We did pass the strength test. Passing the strength test doesn't mean killing the monster, yeah? Just means that we don't lose any health or anything. We got a success, we passed it. So, we get the clue, which is what we wanted. Put that over here, excellent. And what was that about? I hope she gave that bloody ally a good shoeing. Oh yeah, we retreat Doom by 1. So we're up to 18. So although Rex has got a despair condition and Jenny has lost a couple of sanity, we have moved Doom back to 18. So that's excellent. Discard this. Okay, so that is it for Jenny, who's had a very eventful trip to Central America. Next and last for the encounter phase, it is Monterey Jack, and he is over in Rome. And here we are with Monterey. Right, so he's going to have a Rome encounter, which is the orange European deck. Cut. Rome. Focus. The police ask you about a book that the Arturo Regini gave you. Gain 1 tome unique asset. Let's do that first then. So we've got, this is a unique asset deck. As ever, a quick shuffle, although the deck's a bit out of hand because it's too large. But to be fair, you're only supposed to really shuffle it at the beginning. I'm only doing it because we're on video. Right, so a cut, and then we'll take from the bottom until we get a tome asset. Sealing the old ones is a task. Mysterious idol is a relic. Prayer is a task. Cryptic text. This must be a tome. Indeed it is. Action. You attempt to decipher a cryptic message in the text. Test law. If you pass, you uncover secrets that could alter the fate of humanity. Flip this card. So he's a proper archaeologist, isn't he, Monty? Look at that. He's turning up stuff left, right and centre. Good lad. So I'll put that there. We shall continue with the encounter. When you deny having it, they use force. Test strength, minus one. Oh, trying to force it off you, are they, Monty? You're not having that, are you? So he gets, he's got a good strength, he's got four. He does have sort of a reroll on his bullwhip, but that's just combat encounters, so he can't use it for a normal strength test like this is. So he just gets four dice, and he has got a focus. He gets a five, that's a success. Keeps his focus, he doesn't need it, he has passed. If you pass, you feel more confident than ever. Improve will. Woohoo! Oh, quick look for those who want to see what the fail condition was. And it's gone. Okay. Right. So that is that. He improves will. Let's get an improve will token. There we are. And his will has now gone up to three. So Monty is doing extremely well. With a strength of four and a will of three, he's turning into a proper groin puncher. Just the sort of investigator that we need. Oh, hang on. Those were the ones we cycled through. Put them back with the unique asset deck. That is it for the encounter phase. Next up, oh yes, it's the laugh and chuckle phase. Hello everyone, me again, very quickly. What happened there was, this is about 2 hours later, what happened there was I obviously got confused with the encounter, because the encounter involved Monterey getting that unique asset. I just got rid of his treasure map and the clue, but he's resolved an encounter, so now he needs to resolve the treasure map. So I got confused because he actually got a tome. So he is owed something else. So Lawrence, anybody out there is going, I want my reward, we'll do it now. Unfortunately, it means I'm gonna have to upload the thing again, and it took about an hour, but let's get it right. So trinket, when you gain this card from the deck, place one random clue face up on the card. Yeah, after resolving a location encounter, which we've just done, we can flip the card. So let's have a look. Treasure map. As you enter the massive underground library that was marked on your map, you are amazed at the sheer volume of information that must be contained within these tomes. Gain one tome unique asset and improve lore. Excellent. Then discard this card. So now we can discard it. And we're going to get another tome. So he's already got one off Arturo. So we can get rid of the clue now. Correctly. And let's do a quick shuffle. Actually, do it the right way up. And a quick cut, and he will get another tome. So, task. Task. It's going to take ages now, isn't it? To pay me back for doing it wrong. Oh, come on. Relic. Ally. Yeah, we're going to be here. Oh no, here we go. An old journal. Unique asset. Item tome. Action. Test observation. I think his observation's pretty good. If you pass, you discover information that may prove useful to your cause. Flip this card. So he's got an old journal as well. So apologies for that. This is about an hour and a half after I actually finished recording and started uploading. Just very nearly finished the uploading right at the end, and then I was I was looking through the footage and realised I'd missed it in editing as well. So I'm going to have to upload it again. So you'll probably get this in the middle of the night. Okay, back to the earlier footage, and I'll be able to move something back that I just had to move out of the way so I didn't give you a spoiler. But back to the footage. And here we are at the mythos phase. Just a quick thing that I should have done. Whoop, get back to space 11, new clue. Obviously, the treasure map and this clue that said where the treasure map was, they get discarded. So, that was a unique asset, so that goes in there. Okay, and the clue can go back in the box. Excellente. Righty-ho. And what do we want? We want the mythos deck. That's what we want. And it's over here. So here it is. Let us learn the bad news. And it's a reckoning. That is bad news. Sorry, Wendy. And in fact, sorry to poor old Rex as well. Well, we've got movement. Omen track movement. We go to the blue constellation. We have a blue constellation gate, which is Tokyo. So we go down to 17. But we've still got a doom we've still got a doom movement in the bag because we moved it back twice during that turn. Right, after that, it's a reckoning, my favourite. They take ages. So let's go through the mantra. Right, resolve reckoning. So monsters, which is bad. We have a monster with a reckoning. Here it is. It's that horrible fire vampire. So let's have a look what actually occurs. Move this monster two spaces towards the nearest investigator, which is Wendy. Then each investigator on this space loses one health. So Wendy loses a single health. As I understand it, she doesn't have to fight it. Right at the moment, she just loses that health, so that puts her down to 4 health. She does have the elusive ability for next turn, so hopefully she'll be able to give it the slip and get into Tokyo. I don't think she has to fight it. I'll just check after we've done all the reckonings. If she does, then we'll do it. But let's get through the rest of the reckoning phase first. So yes, reckoning. After monsters, it's the ancient one. Do we have a reckoning effect on the ancient one? We do not. So that's easy enough. Put that back. After the ancient one, we have mythos cards. Well, there are none outstanding. Then it is possessions. So going with the first player, we have the blessing. Dun, dun, dun. So Wendy has a blessing. So she's got a roll on it, unfortunately. She's blessed. So come on, Wendy. A 3, she keeps it. That's good enough. She keeps her blessing. Excellent. Is there anything else she needs to roll on possessions wise? No. So we move across to Rex. As far as possessions go, no, he doesn't have to roll. We will return to Rex though shortly. And possessions for Jenny Barnes. None of her possessions require a reckoning roll. And for Monterey Jack, none of his possessions require a reckoning roll. So now it's conditions. Did it wrong way around. I rolled for the condition, didn't I, for Wendy. So not the possession. But she didn't have any possessions. She had to roll for a condition. The only other person who's got a condition is Rex. In fact, he's got 2. Because Rex is lucky like that. So, which one to do first? I think we'll do his curse condition first, before despair. He does lose one sanity, but like I say, we'll do the curse condition first. Seeing as he had that first anyway. On a reckoning, roll a die. Come on, Rex. 4, 5, or 6. Come on. You can do it. A 4. Yes, you can do it. So, he discards the card. He gets it back immediately. So, because he always remains cursed. But, he gains a clue. Let's get the glue bag. I did say clue bag, not glue bag. So, he's got a clue. Brilliant. Got a clue before he dies. He also gets to improve one skill of his choice, I believe. Yep, and he is going to improve his influence again and put it up +2. So he now has an influence of 5. So that is pretty good. He could get the urban guide next turn, assuming he survives, because now he's got to check his despair condition. So when you perform a rest action, you cannot recover sanity. Flip this card. On a rec... Oh, we don't have to flip this card. We only have to flip this card when he does a rest. So on a reckoning, he just loses a sanity. I don't think there's anything he can do to prevent that. No, there isn't. So let's put this 3-1 in and get 2 back. So he is now on 6 sanity. So yes, we only have to flip this actual despair condition when he tries to rest. So he retains that as well. Brilliant. That is the reckoning. I'll just check whether Wendy has to actually fight that fire vampire. Won't be a second. And I'm back. Had to check quickly there because I've been playing Arkham Horror and I didn't want to get it all mixed up. Yep, it's not an ambush. The fire vampire has just moved to a space with an investigator in, and that investigator has had to lose one health, but it is not an ambush. So therefore, you do not have to fight the monster till the encounter phase. We are not in the encounter phase, so Wendy does not have to fight it. Additionally, it also means that during the action phase next turn, Wendy can move away from that monster. So she can just move away from the fire vampire. She don't have to evade it or anything. All she does is move. So she can move to the unguarded Tokyo gate and not have to worry about the fire vampire. Why? Well, the fire vampire won't be on the Tokyo gate, so she should be able to go into the gate immediately. And if she manages to resolve an encounter there, I think it's resolve, so you don't even have to like successfully close the gate, she could go to the Plateau of Leng. In which case, she has well given the fire vampire the slip. So the person that'd have to worry then is guess who? Yes, good old Rex, because he will be 2 movement away at good old San Francisco. But hopefully he will move next turn as well, so the fire vampire won't be able to catch anybody up next turn. But that's good news. So Wendy has only lost 1 health. Unfortunate, but not as bad as it could have been. Right, so that is the end of the reckoning phase. And next up we have Spawner Gate. No! So what is our top gate? It is Istanbul. Green Comet. That's good. We've got quite a while till the Green Comet comes up again. So that goes at Istanbul. Right next to good old Monty. And what's the monster? The monster will be a skeleton. Surely this is easy. There's no reckoning. 2 toughness. You have to do a horror check, get at least 2 successes. That's not too bad. -2 on the strength test, but it is just bones, so I imagine it is a bit difficult to put down. And as long as you get 1 success, you will avoid damage. If you defeat this monster during a combat encounter, you recover 1 sanity. So that's alright. That's a nice monster. We like skeletons. They're okay. Right, so that is our gate. And now we get to the rest of the card. This dark intelligence somehow embedded its maliciousness in its own stories. Little by little, those stories have crept into your mind, poisoning you. Curse of knowledge. Each investigator discards half of his clues, then the lead investigator gains a curse condition. This is why Wendy is our main investigator, her lead investigator. She's going to gain a curse condition. Where are the banes? Around here somewhere. Oh, where are they? There they are. I have a righteous condition on the top of it. One of the ones that doesn't help. So well, there we go. We'll pick from the back. Haunted, blight, haunted, blight, blight. You're joking, it cursed. And it goes right back in. Because it's Wendy Adams. And what's Wendy Adams' special ability? Once per round, if you would gain a non-deal condition or an impairment token, you may choose not to gain that condition or impairment token instead. And she doesn't want a curse condition, so she's not having it. However, clues. This is appalling. Because Rex loses his clue, Jenny Barnes loses a clue, and Wendy Adams. We lose all three of the clues that we had. Because it's Eldritch Horror. And we don't round things down, we round things up. So half of one is one in this game. Aren't we doing well? Aren't we doing well? But at least Wendy has done her job and she has managed to dodge a curse condition. Even if Rex had been first player, that would have been bad news. Because he's got a curse condition, he'd have had to have flipped it over. Not nice. So, really good that we had Wendy as our first player there. But, oh, discarding half clues and rounding up, that is really bad. We've got no clues whatsoever now. So, for it being an easy AO, we're not having a good start. So, that is the end of the Mythos phase. And I won't be unhappy to see the end of that card. No doubt there are worse ones in the deck, but seeing as we need clues to actually achieve our mystery, then that is a real hammer blow of a card for us. And yes, so that's the end of the Mythos phase. It's the end of turn one. I hope everybody enjoyed it. I think we're in a bit of a pickle. I won't do one of my usual turn reviews because of the way that we're playing the game with all the other individuals and viewers. I'll do a bit of a sort of turn review at the start of next turn. We'll go through each investigator, where they're up to, and, you know, what problems we are facing then. Just gives everybody a chance to have a chat about what they think went right, what they think went wrong. But all in all, not a brilliant turn. Not a brilliant turn. Not the worst, by any stretch of the imagination. Could have had a lot of a worse turn than that. But losing them clues, that is bad. Rex getting the despair condition is bad. But, yeah. But we got some nice items. We've managed to cycle through the actual asset reserve very well. We've got some excellent gear waiting to be picked up there, and we did shove Doom back a couple of places. So even though we lost, we got a Doom trap movement, we are still doing better than we did right at the start of the game. Doom is at 17. As I say, we'll come back for turn two, discuss in a little more detail before we crack on. Okay, so thank you so much for watching turn one. Thank you to all the players who have been involved. All their flavour text and all their directions were brilliant. Thank you very much. It was all very clear. If we can keep on in that vein, it should be a lot easier for me. Thank you. Hope everybody who is watching enjoyed it. As ever, if I've messed up anywhere, please let me know. As I say, I've just played a game of Arkham Horror. It may be that I have missed something or got something mixed up. It is not unusual, as Tom Jones would say. So if you've spotted anything like that, please, please let me know. That goes for anybody watching as well as the players. If I've done something wrong, let me know. And thank you all for watching. Thanks for all the views. Thanks for all the subscriptions. Thanks for all the help and support. And thank you so much for going over to Board Game Links to upvote the site. Those of you that have, that is marvellous. Thank you very much. I hope I will see you next time for the next turn of Eldritch Horror, Rise of the Elder Things. But until then, this is me, Catweazle, signing off. Toodaloo.